Hi there, I'm Diana from Office Timeline, and today we're going to explore two ways of creating Gantt charts from your Microsoft Excel data. The first one is a manual method that uses the charts functionality directly in Excel to make a simple Gantt chart. And the second one is a really fast and simple alternative that uses Office Timeline to take the data from your Excel file and turn it into a beautiful Gantt chart in PowerPoint in just a matter of minutes. But before we get going, no matter which method you pick, you need to format your project data in Excel beforehand. Let's begin with that. First, break your project down into tasks and give them titles. These tasks will form the basis of your Gantt chart. Now add a start date and then an end date to each task. We will also need a duration that is expressed in days. And luckily, Excel makes it really simple to calculate that with a formula. All we have to do is take the values from our end date column and deduct the values in our start date column from them. To do this, just select the first cell in the duration column and start writing our formula by typing an equals sign in it. Then hold shift and select the values in the end date column, put a minus sign in the formula, and finally, hold shift and select the values in the start date column, then press enter. And don't forget to save your file to make sure you don't lose your data. And there you go, we have a data table that we'll use as a basis for creating our Gantt charts. Now let's see how we can make a Gantt chart directly in our Excel sheet. Click on any blank cell next to your data table, then click up here to go to the Insert tab. And in the Charts section, click on Bar Chart and then select the stacked bar. Make sure not to select the 100% stacked bar next to it, since that one won't work the way we need it to. Excel has now created a blank chart on our sheet. Let's resize and move it to a better position. Then right-click on it and go to Select Data to open the Select Data Source window. We will now add the start dates for our tasks to the graph. On the left side of this window, click Add. For the top field, select the title cell of your start date column, and for the bottom field, delete the existing text and shift select the date cells in the start date column. Now we will add the duration of the tasks to the graph. Click Add again, and for the top field, select the title cell of the duration row. Then for the bottom field, delete the text and shift select the cells containing the numbers of days from the duration row. Now let's add your task titles to the graph. From the left side of the window, select start date, then move over to the right side and click on edit. Make sure not to click the edit on the left side, since that won't help us. Click on the empty field from the new window and shift select all of your task titles. Now that our data is in the right place, it's time to work on the formatting to make this visual actually look like a Gantt chart. First, let's hide the blue parts of each bar. To do this, click once on any of the blue bars to select all of them. Make sure to click only once, since double-clicking will select just the one bar your mouse is hovering over. Now right-click and select Format Data Series, and a new task pane will appear on the right of the screen. Click on the Fill and Line icon, then open up Fill to check the No Fill Radio button, and open up Border to select the No Line option. Before we finish, let's adjust this graph to make it look a bit better. Let's reverse the order of our tasks so that the task that starts first is at the top. Inside the chart, click once on any of your task titles. Then go back to the task pane to your right and click on the Access Options icon and tick the checkbox called Categories in Reverse Order. Now let's reduce the white space on your Gantt chart by clicking once on the dates above the taskbars and then go to the right pane and try to slightly increase the value for the minimum bounds until your chart looks good. Now go down to the major value for units and try to increase that number until the dates at the top of the chart look better. Let's make our taskbars a bit wider by selecting any of them going to the right panel and clicking on the series options icon and lowering the gap width percentage. Finally, let's recolor our tasks by clicking on the fill and line icon again and changing the color to blue. And there you have it. With some considerable time and effort, we've managed to turn our Excel data into a basic Gantt chart that we can copy and paste into our presentation. As you could see, the process in Excel was quite complicated, and making a Gantt chart shouldn't be so hard. So I'd like to show you an easier way to create a Gantt chart from your Excel data automatically, using Office Timeline. For this option, you'll need Office Timeline installed on your computer. This add-in works directly in PowerPoint and can pull data from Excel and other platforms to generate much more professional-looking visuals than what you can create with Excel alone. Let's take the data table we made at the start of this video and add one more column to the left of the table to include a row ID number for each of our items, and save the file. This step is necessary if we want to update our Excel data after we have created our visual. Open up Microsoft PowerPoint. Go up here to switch over to the Office Timeline ribbon and click Import. And then select Excel. This will open up the Office Timeline Excel Import Wizard. Use it to select your file, then make sure the table header containing the titles of each column is selected and that each column is properly mapped. And finally, select which rows you want to include in your visual. You can select all of them at once by clicking the check mark in the table header. When you're done, click Import, and Office Timeline will automatically generate your Gantt chart in a matter of seconds. And if you edit the data in your Excel file, all you have to do to update the visual in PowerPoint is to save the newly edited file. Then, in PowerPoint, go to the Office Timeline ribbon and click Refresh Data. Ensure that the items you want to update are selected, click Refresh, and Office Timeline will automatically adjust your visual to include your new edits. Pretty quick, right? Office Timeline also makes it easy to change the dates and layout of your Gantt chart by letting you drag and drop items. To do that, go up here to Edit Timeline to open the timeline view. Drag this time scale to adjust the position of the entire chart. You can also add milestones to your Gantt chart. You can drag them left or right to adjust their dates. And you can do the same for tasks. You can drag tasks up and down to change the layout of your timeline. You can put your tasks and milestones into swim lanes and subswim lanes as well. Create a swim lane by clicking on this plus icon, then give it a title. Let's also add a subswim lane to it just to see what it looks like. You can adjust their headers to take up less space, and you can drag items into them. Let's do some final adjustments to our layout, and then click Save. And finally, let's make your visual even more eye-catching. You can either customize its styling in detail with a style pane if you have the time, or you can do what we're going to do and make it look really good in a few clicks by using a predefined theme. Go back to the Office Timeline ribbon and click on Themes. Then Manage and Apply Themes. Browse through the different pre-designed looks that come with the add-in until you find something that suits your Gantt chart. There's a lot more you can do with Office Timeline, including showing dependencies and the critical path, and we cover those topics and more in our other videos, so do check them out when you have the time. When you're done, you can present your visual as is in PowerPoint. You can share it via email, or you can select Copy Timeline to Clipboard to paste it back into your Excel sheet, or any other program that allows you to embed visuals into files. So there you have it, two different ways of creating a Gantt chart from Excel data. While the first method might work for simple projects, office timeline is likely a better fit for more complex projects or if you need to present project updates to executives or stakeholders. Hope you found this video helpful. If so, remember to like and subscribe. And if you feel like giving Office Timeline a test run, come try the add-in for free by downloading it from officetimeline.com. See you next time!